So this is the famous Kariakoo market in Dar es Salaam, Tanzania. It's Dar's biggest market and spans several city blocks. The market is a major contribution to the city's food provision and economy. It's a colourful and busy place where you can buy almost anything. In this video, you will learn the Kariakoo history, architecture, and of course the legendary prices.
Sante.
So make sure you watch this video to the end so you see the prices of fruit and vegetables in this area. Over 200 years ago, a German businessman bought 200 hectares of land in this area. He then rented the land to Africans. After that, Dar es Salaam grew. In around 1913, about 50% of the population in Dar es Salaam lived in this area.
A year later, in 1914, the Germans decided to turn the area into a town. Concrete houses were built for the locals and Kariakoo was established. Then, in 1916, the British conquered and used the area for its military.
The name Kariakoo comes from a British carrier corps that used to be based in the area.
In 1974, local architect B.J. Amuli designed and restructured the market. And this is it.
The 24 large tree-shaped roof funnels and columns allow rainwater to be caught and captured in underground water tanks. The large openings around the sides allow natural ventilation, so the air circulation keeps the interior nice and cool. The funny thing about the building is that the actual market is not inside the building. It's actually immediately around and spans several blocks.
So the building acts like a vacuum for specialised commercial goods. Not actually many people go inside, but let's have a look.
African markets are normally under trees, so Mr. Mully designed the trees out of concrete, which also gives shoppers a welcoming experience.
So the ground floor and first floor are specialised goods, as opposed to the fruit and veg outside. I want to find out where these rainwater tanks are, where the rain funnels collect the rain. Last time I came here, I couldn't find these tanks. I met this guy here, he's going to show me where they are. I think they're in the basement. Well, they should be in the basement. This guy's quite helpful. He's showing me where the rainwater pipe is. Inside, the pipe's inside.
1, 2, 1, 2, 3.
Ah, so it comes down here, then it goes in here. Wow. So this guy's showing me around the basement, which is nice of him. So from 100 kilos,
yeah, 100.
So you buy that from the farm?
Yeah, we buy it.
How much?
100,000.
That's good, eh?
Thank you very much.
So this building has a huge impact on the area and is the heart of the Kariakoo area. So I'm just going to buy some vegetables now.
500.
This is 500.
The avocado is 500 shillings, which is not bad. How much is the potatoes? So it's about 1,500 per kilo for the potato.
Kilo moja.
And these ones? And plastic bags have been banned here recently. That's beetroot here. Kilo. Thank you.
What is that?
So garlic is 10,000 shillings for 1 kilo. Cucumber. How much is that? 1,000 shillings for 3 cucumbers.
Okay. Only 1 British pound for a papaya.
So for onions it's 2,000 shillings per kilo. The carrots are 2,000 shillings per kilo. 1,000 for 3 peppers.
So
mangoes are 1,000 shillings each. I think that's the same as the supermarket.
Mangoes and apples are 1,000 each.
God, the smell of the fish is intense. So the prices in your hometown this cheap? Let me know and I'll see you in another video.